By this analysis curve, the public's taste changes with the times. It isn't enough for an advertising man to have imagination. He has to have a sympathetic eye and ear to what the public wants and what they need. Take clothing styles, for instance. Oh. Now, of course, what we have... What's in that drink?
Root beer?
Root beer and what?
Scotch.
Scotch? What's that?
Gin.
Gin? Give me that. Oh, heavens. There's a towel over there. Will you get it for me, please?
Oh, yes.
You ought to be spanked. What's the matter with you, anyway?
Nothing's the matter with me, and I wish you wouldn't talk to me as if I were 12 years old.
There's been enough of this nonsense.
Well, we haven't done a thing.
We have done all we're going to.
Oh, help! Who's going to break the news to your wife? You have no right to spy on me, Mr. Grogan. This is a free country, and I'm a citizen. Don't let this big clod bother you, Darrin. I suppose you're pretty proud of yourself, aren't you?
She's a very charming person. Something about which you don't have the faintest idea how to be.
Well, what's so unusual about having charm? It comes with age, like wrinkles.
You're jealous.
Me, jealous? You've got to be kidding.
Sure, Liza Randall, the most irresistible thing to come along since Bridget Bardot. You're jealous.
Don't you laugh at me, you monster, so help me.
When a man has a wonderful wife like Samantha, he shouldn't go after a girl like Liza, who's got a boyfriend like me.
His hands. He may never make another pass.
Oh, I don't think that'll stop him.
I think she means football, dear.
Oh, you monster. Come on, Marvin.
Hey, that's the first time you've ever called me Marvin.